The majority of offshore engineering professionals consider communication a too time-consuming task, and only 2% are satisfied with the way they collaborate on their projects today. I believe technology can help us overcome some of these issues and improve on those numbers. My name is Jan, I'm the product manager for CSAM Insight, and I'm going to take you through the top three challenges in how to become more efficient in your offshore engineering projects. I'm saying offshore engineering projects, and by that I mean engineering projects on all types of offshore assets, not only fixed assets as I have depicted here, but the same principles apply to offshore wind turbines, ship type structures, floating assets, you name it. One thing all these projects have in common is that we have people involved, right? We have typically some people from the asset owner or operator side, and we have people carrying out the contract work, typically EPC companies. And in order to make any project a success, obviously these people, they need to communicate with each other. And that is not only true for the two different parties, but also internally in the two organizations, people need to communicate. And what our survey has revealed is that all of this communication, or almost all of it, both between two organizations and within an organization, between departments and units, happens via sending emails. The problem with emails is that in order to not exclude anyone from the communication threads, typically you include a lot of people in the address line, in the CC line, and that leads to people's inboxes being clogged up with information they're maybe not so interested in. On the other hand, if you are interested in one piece of information, it's easy to get lost in all the other information that is being passed around. So what I suggest as an alternative is, rather than sending emails around, we should invite all the project stakeholders to an online workspace where we have all project-related files stored in the cloud, and all these people have access to it, meaning that the collaboration and the communication can happen right there where we have all the other project-related files. The advantage with this is, first of all, we're taking the communication where it actually belongs, which is close to the asset that we're talking about. The second part is, it's very transparent. If you're a project stakeholder, you have access to all the discussions, all the information being exchanged regarding the project. If you're a bit less interested, if you just need to check in occasionally, your email inbox is not being clogged or spammed with all the information that there is. You can go in and request the information that you're interested in yourself. The second challenge we're trying to solve is visualization. What I mean by that and why it is important, it's interesting to take a closer look in what kind of information is being passed around in those emails. Typically, you find, of course, a bunch of text written in the emails. But it's not only that text, it's also file attachments that we typically send around. So, for example, those files may be drawings. And it's not only one file, right? These are typically many drawings. The same applies for example, some spreadsheet calculations, analysis, numbers of all types, and again, a whole bunch of it. Lastly, you will certainly find reports and documentation being sent around. And this can be hundreds of pages of reporting. And the reason we're sending all this stuff around is not because we enjoy writing or reading reports or producing all this material. It is because we don't seem to have a better alternative just as of today. But what I suggest is we can reduce the requirements on the amount of documentation and reports and so on if we had a way to visualize the problem in 3D for all of the project stakeholders. And obviously this 3D visualization, it should happen in the same place where also the communication takes place, which is the collaborative online workspace that we provide. This takes us to our third challenge to solve, which is data integration. There's a reason that we have all these people involved in a project. It's because they all contribute to different parts of the project. They all have their different fields of expertise. And it's basically like they're all contributing a different piece to the puzzle. But in order for the whole project to be a success, obviously all these people need to come together and they need to integrate the data they produce. All their findings and results have to be presented in a holistic way to decision makers and project stakeholders. So this last part, I'm going to show you in a demonstration of CSAM Insight, this cloud-hosted web tool that I talked about earlier. So here we're looking at a fixed production platform visualized in our cloud-based collaboration tool, CSAM Insight. If we take a closer look at the topside part of this asset, you will see these spheres distributed along the topside. And what they represent are inspection points. So somebody has carried out an inspection on this asset and has logged their findings. And apparently there were three severe findings on the topside, visualized by these red dots. Now, if you were to follow up and decide which one of these findings to plan a maintenance campaign for example, this is probably not enough information for you to make that call. That's why it's important to integrate this data with other data sources in order to get the full picture and make the right decisions. So if instead of only looking at the inspection findings, we could overlay that information with, for example, the worst case utilizations that we get from a strength assessment, it will give us much more insight about which ones of these problems to tackle first. For example, it becomes obvious now that probably this is not our best candidate to start fixing the issue. These two are in areas that are much more utilized, where the steel is under much more utilization. So this is probably what you want to focus on first. And it's this kind of data integration or holistic view that we need to provide to decision makers in order for them to make the right calls. If you now have all the project stakeholders and all the people you collaborate with invited onto this online platform, it is very easy to kick off a conversation right here where you had just had an insight or a piece of information that you want to share with others. So I can either log a new comment and describe what I've just found. And the way this will appear for others is when they simply click through a list of all the comments, they will come up right there. There is a discussion thread that is transparent and open for all the project stakeholders to follow. And it's very easy to get a quick overview of the as-is condition of the assets you work with. So by this, I hope you agree that we can improve efficiency in our offshore engineering projects. We can improve collaboration, we can improve visualization, and we can improve data integration in order for our projects to become a success. So let us know if you agree or disagree.